Hey, Remote Pilot 101, Jason here. I am sure you've heard all about it, the Mavic Mini. Its big selling points now are is it doesn't have to be registered. Well, I want to debunk that a little bit. I want to talk about where does the Mavic Mini fit into Part 107, or if you choose to use it for commercial use, as an example. But let's cover the hobbyists and let's cover commercial operations. First, we register, we know, on the FAA's Drone Zone website. In fact, on their current landing page, and you hit it, the very first thing it says right here, register your aircraft using this website if it weighs more than 0.55, 250 grams, and less than 55 pounds. Well, of course, the Mavic Mini clocks in at a whopping 249 grams. So it falls under this registration requirement. So the question people have is, well, if I don't need to register, I don't need to apply by the rules either, right? It's the outlaw drone, as my friend Ken Hare and some others have humorously called it. Nothing could be further from the truth. It may fall under some registration requirements, but it still very much falls under the rule requirements. Let's start with hobbyists. If I want to operate this as a hobbyist, I'm held to the rules under Part 101. In this case, look on your screen with me, 101.41, applicability. And talks about this subpart prescribes rules governing the operation of a model aircraft or an aircraft being developed as a model aircraft that meets the following requirements. We continue down. I want you to focus on subpart C right there. The aircraft is limited to not more than 55 pounds unless otherwise certified through design. It continues on through construction, everything else. This is important. It defines an upper limit, 55 pounds. It never defines a lower limit like we just previously did on the FAA Drone Zone website, because that is a registration requirement only, not a rule requirement. So part 101, the hobbyist rules, are from no weight to 55 pounds. Look now at subpart D with me here. The aircraft must be operated in a manner that does not interfere and gives way to manned aircraft, and subpart E, when flown within 5 miles of an airport. We all know the 5 miles of an airport rule for hobbyists. So again, they don't define a minimum to fly by the rules there. So what about now for commercial use? What if I just want to use this for some basic mapping? Maybe this is my recon drone before I send up the Inspire 2 or whatever it is. I want to use this for commercial purposes. So for commercial purposes, we look in part 107.3. Let's define what a small unmanned aircraft is. It means an unmanned aircraft weighing less than 55 pounds. And this is important because this is both for hobbyists and for part 107 operators. 55 pounds, less than 55 pounds on takeoff. Now, further on, we'll define registration a little bit later here, but it's less than 0.55 or less than 250 grams on takeoff. Think about this for a second. Do you think an SD card, even a micro SD card, weighs at least a gram? What if you want to put those prop guards on? Well, you just want to throw some stickers on it or whatever it is. Do you think you're over 250 grams now at your takeoff weight? It needs to be registered. That number is based on takeoff weight, as it says here in 107 and also says in part 48 that it will reflect to our hobbyists in part 101, including everything on board or otherwise attached to the aircraft. Now, what about registration for commercial use? 107.13 spells that out for us. A person operating a civil small unmanned aircraft systems for the purposes of flight must comply with the provisions of 91.203. You feel like in the Code of Federal Regulations, they just send us from reg to reg to reg. No one wants to just spell it out plainly in one page, but don't worry. We pulled it for you. Here's 91.203, civil aircraft certifications required. Be very careful with the verbiage here. An effective U.S. registration certificate issued to its owner. So we have to have, under Part 107, an effective U.S. registration certificate issued to its owner, or as it continues on, for operation within the United States or operations outside of the laws of a foreign country, that they have their own registration requirements there. So here is the solution for you. For hobby use, must you register under Part 101? No, you don't need to register unless you plan on putting in the SD card and prop guards and stickers, and now you're over 250 grams, 250 and greater. You don't need to register if you're going to just fly it stock as it is. Do you still have to follow the hobbyist rules? Absolutely, you still have to follow the hobbyist rules. Commercial use under part 107, do you need to register it? The answer is absolutely yes. You do need to register your Mavic Mini if you plan on using it for commercial purposes. Listen, this is not the outlaw drone. I don't have to register it. I'm gonna break all the rules and do whatever I want. There's just a little, you know, DJI got creative with some marketing is what it really is, and good for them for doing it and really creating a new market segment or broadening a current market segment as far as that goes. Just be mindful and watch the accessories and watch those takeoff weights. I think the Mavic Mini, we actually have one heading this way to Remote Pilot 101 Studio soon to kind of share with you all and do some flying as well. I think it's gonna be a great, fun little device. I think it's gonna introduce a lot of people to a growing and awesome industry as well. So listen, any questions you have in the comments below this video on YouTube, on Facebook, on remotepilot101.com. Last little thing here. If you haven't heard, this month, this is November, by the way, this month we're giving away Remote Pilot in Command t-shirts by remotepilot101.com. Links to that are in the video description as well. We're giving away 500 of them. So high probability of winning a shirt there. So the link is in there. Again, we'll protect your information. No spam, nothing like that. So all that is kept safe with us. So listen, can't wait to read your comments. Can't wait to see you win a t-shirt. We'll see you all in the next video.